on the wheel. Today is Wednesday. I'm in bed at the moment, obviously. I stood outside the bungalow. Been ordering some bits for the lorry. So he managed to find the corner window for the driver's door on on eBay. So we've ordered that. Then we've had to sort of start thinking about power and light and heat and things and the best system to do that. So what after a lot of backwards and throwing as to what's best, I know the back, Liam's going to be doing all sorts of different things with 12 volts and everything else in the back, but obviously I need to get some power in the front here. And that can also be used with the system later as well. So we're going down the split charger route, and obviously with Grace being a 24 volt truck, that means I've got to get a 24 volt split charger. So order that. Then of course that has to go to batteries. Need at least minimum two batteries. So I've got two electric batteries coming. Then of course need the inverter to transform it or change it or whatever. So at this point, there's much money left, so I just went for whatever I could afford. So then I had to get a 24 volt. And actually, I found one that actually said truck and horse box inverter. So I got one of them. So that's all on the way this week. So obviously I'm stuck here waiting for that to come. We've had no sort of toots of the horns or bangs on the door or anything yet. Fingers crossed that's okay. So I've got essentially even my heat coming in here. So I made a nice running board for Bentley to come in and out onto, and he's going through the hole lovely now. So that saves a lot of trouble, and he's teaching him to use that really nicely, and I'm really pleased that he's doing that. I let the kittens out just for like a few minutes the other day. I didn't yesterday. Yesterday I spent time after making those orders. I then had to figure out where they're going to go. So I had to empty the whole of my loo cupboard, wardrobe cupboard or storage cupboard that was full of all the tools and things. So I had to take all that out yesterday, backwards and throwing, putting them into the bungalow. Oh, I had a shower yesterday morning as well. My annual shower. No, I was actually stood in that shower for ages. You know, I was just really needed that. I was just sort of standing there thinking, and I'm still grateful. I'm grateful that I've got the cats and Grace still. I'm so lucky to have Grace. No matter what state she's in, I'm so lucky that they never took her away when she was attempted theft anyway in Waffling. So that space is ready now to put everything when it arrives. So what I'm basically doing then, I've had to go through all the bags to try and find the indicator stalk thing that I'd bought to be replaced, that's been broken. So I had to go through every bag to find it. Oops, sorry, I didn't mean to drop you. And so I've just got like the one bag in there of all the things that need to be fitted so I can find it all. So when the batteries come, I'll put them in. When the everything that needs to be doing next is going to go in that cupboard. So then also when I go off to, or somebody comes here to sort things, I can just say, oh, there it all is. I tied up the back a bit more as well. I got rid of all the surplus boxes, the surplus stuff that I don't need. I took the gas standalone heater thing out that I need a new bottle for. It's huge and I don't not use him. I thought, well, that can go. I'm not going to carry that around for no reason. And that sort of gave me a lot more space in the back there. So I managed to put the chair in its place. So at the moment, there's a seat in the back there. And I might be able to fit in a nice, comfortable cane seat or something. We'll wait and see. I did toy with the idea of moving the, that's Cleo doing her clearing out. I did toy with the idea of actually swapping the, moving the fireplace again, the wood burner fire, put a comfy chair next to the kitchen. But I think it's all right where it is in this place, because obviously if I'm going to have a shower cubicle over the bath as well, then obviously with the fire having a wall going up, that can be incorporated into it. So it's still the best way around. Cleo! They're going through morning ablutions. I also haven't posted blogged much because after the dog fight with coming back from the farm, Connie's not been very well at all. She stopped eating. She was getting a little bit of liquids down her, but you know, I was really scared. I thought I was losing her. She wouldn't let me touch her. She was grumbling, fighting, growling at the babies. And yesterday was at the point where I was actually in tears, thinking that I was starting to say my farewells to her. Anyway, by some miracle, yesterday she took a mouthful of tuna. She'd been going on the wheel like for a few steps every day, still trying to do that. She had a little bit of tuna, and I'm pleased to say today, she seems to be back to her normal self. She's tucked into some dinner. She's washing herself. She's looking a lot better. So I don't know what the hell's going on there, but my God, I thought I was going to lose Connie as well. But yeah, fingers crossed she's getting better now. And that makes me so happy. That was going to be a real emotional thing to lose. I still don't know if she's okay or not. But anyway, hopefully she is. And they're all happy. So Bentley is saying, I'm the well of a time going in and out of his hole. He'll come in and come and go, and then he'll just sit and lie in there and watch the world go by. And yeah, he loves that. Obviously, when hello, sweetie, when we're parked at somewhere different, then he should be, you know, not so frequent. But whilst he's here, can I just talk about you? But whilst he's here, it's his home at the end of the day, isn't it? Yeah, he's enjoyed it, but he's coming back to the lorry, and that's the wonderful thing. He's coming back to the lorry to sort of be fed, go to sleep, and to sit in his books. So even he's shown that he accepts grace and wants to be here. So I look forward to being on the road again, but obviously it's a matter of if I've got to get straight. I also did my list of all the readings and work I've got to do. So I've got to try and get on with that as well. I've got drums to paint, I've got readings paid for that I've got to be caught up on. I've got to get ready for my first show, which is Derby, in the first week or so, March, the one it is. So obviously I've got to get my stock together, get some more painting and wood done, some little bits together, get a stock box together that I can just take in, because obviously I'll be just wheeling it from the car parts. I don't want to carry too much stock, I just want to sort of carry one tub. I've got wheels, but I need to like downsize the amount of stuff I sort of take in to sort of throw on the table, because you know, I won't have much. I found out I am doing a speech there. So I have the end of the day. So if I get exhausted, I'm going to go straight to bed afterwards. So I'm just doing the end of the day talk on the Saturday and nothing else. So just a retail table during the day, and then a talk Saturday afternoon, from which I may take some, you know, bookings. We'll wait and see. I've actually put on there, I'll be talking about my drums as well. So I'll have to sort of dig out some drums to take to demonstrate the looks of it, but you know, I could just talk about them. Anyway, just doing a vlog from the bed, show you I'm okay. Slowly getting through it and enjoying being here, to be honest. I mean, I'm just glad I've got the extension lead to put the radiator on because it's been so cold. There's lots to do, obviously, to make this place proper livable. I'm sort of walking around a lot of stuff, but yesterday I haven't been eating either, to be honest. I was obviously a bit depressed. Yesterday I managed to get the Ridge Monkey out and had some egg on toast. And I also cooked a proper meal, so I cooked fresh potatoes, fresh carrots, and I had some steak in the freezer in the bungalow, so I took that out and had a nice meal last night. So that was a proper meal. I enjoyed that as well. I forget, obviously I'm cooking here with the little camping stove with the gas canisters, and yeah, that was really nice. real butter on it. So getting myself into sort of kitten's jumping around. Cleo and Cayman playtime. I haven't done that yet them yet. So yeah. I just want to say thank you to everyone's support. I know I put a plea out to say, you know what, I'm so confused over what I need regarding, you know, all this off-grid electrics and things like that. But I hopefully got something that's right, that will work. So thank you for your advice and help regarding that. Life goes on. I'm blessed to have my cats, I'm blessed to have Grace. I'm blessed to still be here. And I know there's still a big journey ahead. I've got lots to do. I'm still trying to motivate myself to do things, but you know, this bed is nice. I'm glad I've actually got made this makeshift bed, and it is 3 foot, like I say, but not the 2 foot, 2.5 foot. So much to do, but like I say, it's always going to be a long-term project. Wasn't matter to do it right now, and it's obviously being difficult trying to sort of get on with doing stuff straight away. I still not got the windows the broken windows sorted, but I put as in glass or perspex yet. But I put bubble wrap over them. So actually, with the heater on, it's getting quite warm in here again. So we know that's working. And obviously, as soon as I've got that window done in the cab, then I've been much happier. That, you know, obviously then. A bit of security. But yeah, I mean, I'm actually really pleased with the running board as well. It was only a bit of leftover wood from the build, from the table, I think, in Destiny, actually, which is nice, a nice touch. Oh, and it sits there lovely. It needs painting out, but it works. Oh, that's something else. I tried putting Destiny on eBay yesterday, but I did all this stuff, got it all sort of advertised and pushed to review it and send it and everything, and it just disappeared. Just disappeared. So, obviously, wasn't meant to go yesterday. I'll probably try and do that again. It's obviously she needs to go. I need to get some funds in. But that's it. That's your Wednesday vlog. Wednesday from under the duvet. I've no idea what I look like. I can't see myself without my glasses. Hopefully not too bad. But I mean, the state that I've been posting myself in after the last vlog, well, you know, warts and all that. But, you know, it's, I want to share a journey. I want to keep it real. Show everything that I'm going through, and we'll catch you soon. Bye for now. Just letting Cayman out, doing one at a time. Hi Bentley, you see I've just made a little lift off running track for Bentley to get in and out of. Any other ones, hopefully they'll be sort of having the steps and jump up onto that. I've got screws, just to lift off. Hopefully that'll do. Probably be alright to leave it on, but I'm going to make it so it lifts on and off, just when it parts up, and I'll see it's there. So then Bentley will hopefully jump up and get into the hole, okay? Where you going, Pet Cayman? Where you going? Come on! Anyway, just giving him a bit of exercise. Bentley's waiting to go in, aren't you, Bentley? He's got to learn to go in the hole around the steps now. Good boy! He just come this. You want to go in? You going in? Good boy! Cayman and Cleo out. Let's let them have a little bit of a stretch and a play. What are you doing? This way, come on. Teach them that they're on the tether. I don't want them going too far. This side of the lorry, off the tyres. The babies. Good boy, Bentley. Right, so I'm just, I'm going to see him or not. Just let the babies have their first. Whee! What's that, Cayman? Time out on the zip line at the bungalow. Come on, babies. Bentley's here with us, aren't you? You helping? Good boy. I can't have the other big cats as well because he's just trying to control all these. Cayman! She's trying to get back in, looking tangled round the wall. So I've got to be aware of that. Obviously, they want a bit of run and get back in the lorry, which is what they're being trained to do. Good babies. So ideally, these need to be tied to the lorry, but I haven't got the hooks on yet. Good girl. And good babies. He's a good baby. So they also, if I have them on that side, they're also going to go into the lorry and onto the road. Cayman. Good babies. What are you doing, Cleo? Cayman.
Yeah, but
All right, okay. So good baby. See, they're waiting to run in because the postman was about. Good boy, K-man. Very good boy. I'm sitting down there with Bentley. Come on in and come back out here. Come on in, K-man. Come on in. K-man. Oh, got a good boy running back to the van. Good boy. Come here. Oh. Good babies. I'm going to sit back down with Bentley. See if they follow me or not. Okay, man, you come in. Good boy. Hello, Bentley. Yes, you've been out for a long time this morning, haven't you? You have. Come on, the babies. Okay, man's found the tree. What are you doing up there, K-man? What are you doing up there? Oh, yeah, Cleo. Good girl. Hey. Good babies. What are you doing? You good babies. Good babies. What's that? Good babies, good boy Bentley looking after the babies. What's Cleo doing? Caveman. He doesn't like being restricted, he likes to run free. That's better, they can knock on that door. And obviously they can be coming back to the lorry. Where's Cleo going? Oh, Caveman's tangled. No, he's got to sort that out. You tangled. That way. Got to go that way. Good boy. Yay, K-man. Good boy. Clever boy. It's a clever boy. Look, Cleo. Good boy, Bentley. He's a clever boy, K-man. Where'd you go, Cleo? Where'd you two go in? Right, Cleo? What you doing? It's just all new to them, all the outside smells and grasses and birds, cards and people. They've also got to start doing a slow introduction. And here are Connie and Mischief's in season, so she's yawning anyway, but you can hear Connie wanting to come out with them. Good girl, good boy. Good girl. Who's impatient? What are you doing on there? Hey? What are you doing on there? You can come out in a minute. You haven't got a harness on. Good girl, Connie. Just wait. You feeling better? Hey? She's definitely feeling better if she wants to come out. Good girl. Now I've got Chief and Connie out. Just gotta lock these babies in. It's just too dangerous to have the babies running loose here with the cars. Hey, what are you doing? Oops, Teddy. You're tied up, Chief. Just calm down. Good girl. Connie. Good girl. So one high, one low. Like I said, I've just got to get some hooks on here that I can obviously reach from up here and we'll be sorted. You've gone contangled, Connie. Good boy, Bentley. Did you, good girl? I'm going to go down and untangle them.
Well, Connie's definitely feeling better because she's letting her babies feed on her again. And she was even clawing at the door to go out earlier again. But like I said, I'm not making that into a habit. I can go out for a little bit of exercise, but don't want to get in demand and they've got to get used to being in here. Good girl, Connie. She's in a much better mood. She wouldn't let the babies go anywhere near her for like the last 5 days. Hopefully she's feeling much better now. It's nice to see, isn't it? Good girl, Connie. Yes, I know you're in season, aren't you, Mischief? Hey? What happened to those Sammy babies I wanted? Hey? No babies for Mummy? Hey? Caveman! Yes, you. Good boy. Mischief, hello? And Bentley is up in that top bed up there. He's just come in. Those little books. Did you? What are you up to? You see, the heater's on, it's dark already, it's night time. Bentley's box walk through to the outside, it's all shut up now. What a nice fire, Chief. There you go. I've just been writing up my diary so I can see what my time scale is of all the things I've got to do. I've been folding clothes today, rolling clothes. Just doing more general tidying. I've got more things to build in the van, but I'm taking deliveries today, and it's having a bit of a lazy day, I suppose, really. I just do my to-do lists. I'm working on this vlog at the moment, or up to this point. Getting that loaded up. Oh yes, I put Destiny on for sale on eBay. You know, everything's on there at that moment, so I can't see it being sold on there, but it'll just generate some interest, see what sort of price it gets to. I think 500 quid is probably the beginning bid at the moment. We'll see what happens. What will be and all that. I'm not really trying very hard at the moment to do anything like that. I still need her to run around, really, but if she's going to go now, she's going to go now. Mischief, what are you doing? Bentley's up there, sweetheart. What are you doing up there? Hey, Gigi, good girl. Cat's been climbing up this door and up this wire. She might show you in a minute. Bentley's up there. What are you doing? Yeah, they have to reverse down there. Look, so what they've been doing, they've been jumping on the bed, onto the cat bed there, climbing up the window wire, up into the wood up there, over to Bentley's bit. I'm basically walking around in a circle that way. You waking Bentley up, Mischief? Are you pretty girl? Wow, wow. Good girl. Mrs. Ian. Oh, the window glass came today for the side window. I'm looking for some paint now. Ian said he can pump the tyre up. He's got a mobile compressor for that. So all things are falling into place. We haven't sort of got done yet. It's just obviously just getting things prepared. And everything. Yes, I know. She's in season, so she's not going to stop yowing. We have this like yowing a lot louder than this through the day and the night for about between 5 and 7 days. Can you imagine what it's like having females. What are you doing? You're going to show you climb? Yeah, you're going to climb? Oh, that's a bit risky going that way around. Can you get to it from there? I know Bentley's in your way, isn't he? Oh, she'll go that way instead. You're going to climb up now? My leg was hanging at the bed just now and I've got huge scratch marks where I forget to put my legs in the bed. There's kids outside making a noise. I've just been tapping on my window. But you know, that's not malicious. It's just the mist about first bit of tapping I've had, to be fair. That's only because I'm in here with the light on working. Good girl, Connie. Pretty girl. You feed your babies. Good Tony. See, it's Chief trying to get out the door. They want to go. You're not going out for a walk. You wait till tomorrow now. That's what Connie was doing earlier. Look, they said, well, we know we can go out that way. We can go outside in the garden. So this is what happened then. They start asking to go out, which is I start letting them out. Look, on the leaves. No. No. You've got a wheel. Go on the wheel. Good girl, Connie.